Now we have to learn a special formula, right? So I'll give it a name as special formula only. This is related to three items. It is a factorization formula only. I'll write the expression a cube plus b cube plus c cube minus 3abc. This can be factorized in two ways. One way is a plus b plus c into a square plus b square plus c square minus ab minus bc minus ca. So this is one way of factorization of a cube plus b cube plus c cube minus 3abc. There is one more way in which this can be factorized. It is written as half of a plus b plus c into this whole thing transforms into a minus b whole square plus b minus c whole square plus c minus a whole square. Alright, so this is the second one. So please understand that this expression a cube plus b cube plus c cube minus 3abc can be factorized in two ways. One is a plus b plus c into a square minus a square plus b square plus c square minus ab minus bc minus ca. And the other is half of a plus b plus c into a minus b whole square plus b minus c whole square plus c minus a whole square. Right? Now why is this important? Because there are some direct questions asked on this, on a special case of this. Let's say if we say that a cube plus b cube plus c cube minus 3abc is 0, then what will happen? Then as you can see, either it will be, see, if a cube plus b cube plus c cube minus 3abc, if this becomes 0, then this whole product becomes 0. Now if the product becomes 0, that means any one of them can be 0. So it will be either a plus b plus c equal to 0, or this a square plus b square plus c square minus ab minus bc minus ca is equal to 0, or a minus b whole square plus b minus c whole square plus c minus a whole square, this whole thing is equal to 0. Now what does it mean? Let's see. So as we said, if a cube plus b cube plus c cube minus 3abc is 0, then either this case or this case or this case. Now from the first one, I'll write it again. The first one is, it'll be a plus b plus c, that is equal to 0. Or the second one is a square plus b square plus c square is equal to ab plus bc plus ca. And the third one, look at this very, very closely. Third one is the most important one. What happens? This is a minus b whole square. This is b minus c whole square. This is c minus a whole square. Now, no square can be less than 0. The lowest value of a square that it can attain is 0. Now, the sum of three squares is 0. Now, squares are always positive or 0. Now, if their sum is 0, that means individually, each one of them has to be 0. Remember, the squares can never be negative. Now here the sum of these squares is 0, so each one of them individually has to be 0. So if a minus b is 0, that means a is equal to b. If b minus c is equal to, that means b equal to c. And if c minus a is equal to 0, that means a equal to c, right? So this means that if a cube plus b cube plus c cube minus 3abc is 0, then these are the three conditions which will be applicable, right? And vice versa also. Right? For us, the vice versa or the reverse is more important. Right? Let's take the reverse. What happens? Let's say if I give you that a plus b plus c is equal to 0, then what can you say about a cube plus b cube plus c cube? Let's look at it. We have already seen that a cube plus b cube plus c cube minus 3abc, that is equal to a plus b plus c into a square plus b square plus c square minus ab minus bc minus ca, or whatever it is. If a plus b plus c is 0, then automatically we get that a cube plus b cube plus c cube minus 3abc will become equal to 0 into something. Now 0 into something is always 0. So this means that a cube plus b cube plus c cube is equal to 3abc. You can apply it directly without going into the detailed process. This, if it is given that a plus b plus c is 0, you can directly say that a cube plus b cube plus c cube is equal to 3abc, right? So this is a very good situation. This is a very important situation, right? I repeat, if a plus b plus c is 0, you can directly say that aq plus bq plus cq is equal to 3abc. Let's take one more situation. If I say that a is equal to b is equal to c, then what can you say about aq plus bq plus cq? Look at this again, right? So if I say this aq plus bq plus c cube minus 3abc, what was the second formula of factorization of this? The second formula was half into a plus b plus c into a minus b whole square plus b minus c whole square plus c minus a whole square. Look at this closely. If a is equal to b, then a minus b will be 0. If b is equal to c, then b minus c will be 0. If c is equal to a, then c minus a will also be 0. So 0 plus 0 plus 0 will become 0. The second part becomes 0. So which is equal to something into 0, which is equal to 0. This means aq plus bq plus c cube minus 3abc is equal to 0. This means that if a is equal to b is equal to c, we can directly say that aq plus bq plus c cube is equal to 3abc. Right? This you have to memorize. This is a very special formula, and sometimes there are direct questions asked on this. Alright? So we have completed the required set of algebraic formula for our exams.